I'm glad to get the opportunity to talk on this very important matter here on behalf of farmers and landowners right around the county of Kerry. And indeed, we've been hurt by designations before, and no proper compensation given to the farmers. Indeed, I have said previously here in Dáil Éireann that we know it's a terrible thing when a farmer's house is broken into, or maybe when they've gone to mass and things taken and money taken, and then maybe elderly farmers beaten inside their homes and robbed and their goods and money taken. But when government or when Europe decides to designate a whole farm and maybe adjoining farms and designated, and I've nothing against the Hin Harrier or anything like that, but they designated farms for the Hin Harrier, and they actually robbed the farmers in broad daylight, daylight robbery I call it, without proper compensation, and the farmers had to fight and agitate to get some small amount. And just to give you an idea, you have places in Brosna and out that side where the Cuilte and other forestry owners planted forestry, and maybe the next door neighbour then, when it came to him applying for the plant, he's refused because it's deemed designated for the Hin Harrier. So it's daylight robbery, and it's very, very unfair. And then I have mentioned here in the last number of days where a farm, 365 acres, was designated SAC. And the young fella wanted to build a house on the farm, and in their wisdom, Kerry County Council said, look, there's 365 acres, it's all in SAC, but they at least deserve to get a house, the son deserves to get a house, and granted him planning permission so that he could live alongside his mother, and as his father had died and she wasn't able to drive. And lo and behold, on Tashke, what did they do? Appealed it to Board Pinala and lost, and the young fella lost the planning permission that was granted by Kerry County Council, who went through everything and see that was no harm in the world and only good. And the planning permission was turned down, and that's where the woman finished up on her own. People had to come and bring her and come back and bring her home. And that wasn't right. She lived out the last days of her life, the last few years, on her own. And that's not fair or right. So I'm very worried about these designations. And we've been told that it could, more than 30% of the land of the country could be designated SAC, and that the land that was previously designated SAC, that you could never again touch it or do anything with it, farm it in any fashion or way. So what kind of robbery is that? It's pure robbery. And to contemplate doing such a thing. And this is by the agitation from the Green Party, both in Ireland and Europe, and tis there at the back of this, trying to paralyze and finish farmers forever, or finish farming and return it back to what it was after the Ice Age. And we have to think of people first. We have to think of small families that keep the light shining in the valley, and keep the place alive. If you don't have people, there's no life. Wildlife and everything.
Deputy, just on a point of clarification, you can continue. This debate has to stop within the time. And you can continue talking, but your colleague wants to get in. And just in fairness to the minister, lots of things have been said, and the minister deserves the right of reply. But I can't stop you. You can, but I'm just pointing that out to you.
I'll be very brief. I'm asking the minister here to not ram designations down the farmers' throats and to do it to do it behind their backs. I'm asking that you give the people of Ireland, the people of Kerry, the chance to make submissions if you're producing maps and going to designate more lands SAC and what type of designation you're putting on them and advise them of the implications that will have for planning permission and for farming into the future, because if you don't do that, you're robbing their livelihoods and you're robbing their lives from them. If we don't be fair with them and give them a chance to make submissions, whether to the single farmer, whether to the farming organisations or the landowners, generally they have to get a chance to make submissions and let them know what you're proposing to do, and don't ram it down their throats without giving them a chance.